Hey there, I'm making this video for those of you who are worried about the COVID-19 vaccine. I just had my vaccination this morning, so it's exactly 12 hours from the time of my vaccination. And I've spoken to many people before my vaccination and even after my vaccination. And I hear many people sharing a lot of questions or sharing their fear of taking the COVID-19 vaccine. At the end of this video, I will also share how I felt throughout the day as well as how I'm feeling right now. If you look at our videos, you will know that people love our review videos because we are extremely honest about our reviews and we always make sure that we do tests or experience it ourselves before we make a proper review. So if you would love to travel with us and learn more about products and services that will benefit your life, please remember to help us by liking this video, subscribing to us, and turning on the notification bell. With that, let's talk about the COVID vaccine. Now, if you haven't watched the video that I made when I was getting my COVID vaccine, please do catch it first and then come back here. And in this video, we will share a bit more about what happened after the COVID vaccination. Before the vaccination, I was really excited to go for the vaccination because I really wanted to get the vaccine. It's not that I fear getting COVID. People who are always around me know that I do not really worry about the virus, but I really wanted to get a vaccine because it's kind of like an insurance thing. At the rate that the coronavirus is spreading, it's just a matter of time that everybody may get the virus. And because of that, I decided that, look, why not just go for the vaccine? I understand that many of you are worrying about the vaccine because there have been a lack of trials and it is kind of rushed. It is so fast that they actually create this vaccine and suddenly it's administered to many people. So the side effects are not really known, and for those that we know have side effects, don't seem to be very good, like heart inflammation. And you know, there have been cases of, it's not proven that it's because of vaccine, but there have been cases where people take the vaccine and then after a while they pass away due to heart attack or other symptoms. Because of all these things, people are very afraid to take the vaccine. However, you have to take note of one thing. It is true that it is scary to take the vaccine, but you have to understand that the fact remains that the coronavirus is spreading rapidly. Look at every country that is trying to battle the coronavirus. If it was something so easy as staying home and it can be contained, then everyone would have gotten rid of the coronavirus from the start, right? So it is not easy to get rid of this virus. It spreads very fast, and it's just a matter of time, if you ask me, that everyone will actually come to rubs or friction with the coronavirus. And because of that, it is so essential to protect ourselves, and that's when the vaccine is really needed. So it is a matter of weighing whether you will want to definitely get the virus, and then you try to let your immunity system fight it and hope that you are one of those who is asymptomatic. That's the hope. Or the second case is to take the vaccines and hope for the best that the vaccine really does work. And so far it seems that the vaccine does work. So maybe there are side effects, but one is a confirmed case that if you do not take the vaccine, it's a sooner or later thing that you will get the virus. Or the other case is when you get a vaccine, you may or may not have any side effects. So when I weigh these two this way, or when you weigh these two this way, my personal opinion is that taking the vaccine would be the better choice. So that is to answer those of you who have shared with me that the main reason why you're not taking the vaccine is because you fear the vaccine is being too rushed, or rather it's been rushed out too fast and it may not be very safe to take the vaccine. I was really excited, so when I went in, I really wanted to know how fast this whole vaccination would take, okay? And I went in at 8:56 and I was done. That means I was in the waiting area by 9:03. The whole thing took 7 minutes. That is really fast, and people were just, you know, streaming in and going out. And that includes walking in registration, injection, explanation, and then walking to the waiting area. So there is a general long path that you have to take. For you who is watching this and you have not taken the vaccine, or maybe you have taken the vaccine and you want to know the later part how it would feel, then don't worry about it, okay? The chances of anything happening to you is so low. So let's talk now about the major part of this video, which is the biggest question: how does it feel like after you take the vaccine? Now, I will keep you updated on how I feel like, but this is the update I have for you. 12 hours, exactly 12 hours after taking my vaccination. So right after the vaccination, I went out and I spent the day doing my work. So half the day was spent doing my work, and the other half of the day I was venturing around, somewhat like a light hike, okay, walking around the park. There was some climbing here and there, but it's not something which is like going into the forested area, so it was not that tough. The effects started to kick in, I would say, around an hour after the vaccination. But at that point of time, the worst of the worst case of this effect after 12 hours is the feeling of a young kid. Now, I have to stress the word a young kid, because of course, if you get hit by the car or an adult, it would be very pain. But I want you to imagine a 12-year-old or an 11-year-old kid coming to you and just taking a fist and just punching you this way. So of course, there is a little pain, but the pain isn't very overbearing. It's just that you know it's there. The annoyance is in knowing that there's something there. It's just like if you put your finger at your neck now, and you can be talking like I'm talking this way, if you can follow me, just put your finger at your neck. It doesn't hurt you, right? It's just that it's annoying because you know that there's something pressing onto your neck. So it's the exact same thing on my arm. It's just this feeling of like a young kid going over and just punching, and you know it's there. It's like now I don't feel it at all. Okay, now it's like 12 hours later, I don't feel it at all. But if I want to feel it, I can. All I need to do is to move my hand up this way. Okay, so when I move up to around perpendicular to my body, then I start to feel a pain around the injection area. So it's just a 2-inch area where you feel the pain. So after feeling that pain for 1 hour, throughout my whole day, I didn't really feel the pain at all. It was not there. It's just that annoyance knowing that the pain is there. And until now, there is no pain if I don't move my arm much. It only comes in if you move your arm. Another way of describing this feeling, for most of you, would be sometimes you're sleeping and just your hand just goes in the wrong angle, and you wake up and then you feel that tinge of irritating pain there. That's the exact feel that you have, alright? And that's how I feel 12 hours after the vaccination. Overall, I would say it's a painless process from the start till the end, and that there's only this annoyance that remains on your arm. It's not something that impedes whatever you need to do. I can of course just do anything I want now. Like you see, when I do this kind of stretching also, I don't feel anything impeding my movements at all. I will come back again in 12 hours tomorrow morning and share with you what differences I feel. Remember to like, subscribe and turn on the notification bell, and I'll let you know every 12 hours how I feel until the point which I don't feel any pain at all. So with that, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much. Stay cool, stay awesome, and be your best always. Bye.